हेलो फ्रेंड्स, इन द सीरीज ऑन द इनकम टैक्स केसेस टुडे वी विल डिस्कस ए मैटर वेयर द इनकम टैक्स ऑफिसर ओपन्स द असेसमेंट ऑफ एन एसएससी ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द इंफॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम द कमर्शियल डिपार्टमेंट कमर्शियल टैक्स डिपार्टमेंट दैट देर आर सम अकाउंट्स इन द नेम ऑफ द एसएससी व्हिच हैज नॉट बीन इनकॉर्पोरेटेड बाय द एसएससी into his return of income and make some additions, and if that matter is pending before the CIT appeal, so in that case whether the commissioner of income tax has the power to reopen the same matter under section 263 if the matter is pending before the CIT appeal. In the present case, the matter is related to Rajesh Kumar Jalan versus Principal Commissioner of Income Tax, which has been reported in 113 ITR Tribunal at page number 188, and the matter has been decided by Honorable Kolkata ITAT C Bench, and the date of the judgment is 12th June 2024. In the present case, the assessee was filing his return of income under presumptive income, that is under section 44 AD, at the rate of 5%, and 2 years were involved in the present case, and in both the years the returned income by the assessee was 4 lakh and 5 lakh. The assessing officer received the information from the commercial tax department that there are 7 accounts in the name of the assessee in which some proprietary firms are running, and he issued the notice under section 148, and during the assessment proceedings the learned assessing officer made a little bit sensible order by taking 8% of the turnover and completed the assessment. Although during the assessment proceedings also the assessee has said that the assessee has filed an FIR and these accounts do not belong to him. He is a poor fellow and he cannot be assumed to be the owner of 112 crore. These transactions do not belong to me, but the assessing officer, without making any inquiry, made the addition of 8% of the total turnover of 112 crore. Although in some cases, it has been seen that the assessing officers make the assessment of the whole amount, but in the present case, it can be said that the assessing officer has made a very justifiable order. After that, assessee filed the appeal before the CIT appeal. The matter was pending before the learned CIT appeal, and then Commissioner of Income Tax issued the notice under section 263 to the assessee on the pretext that in the present case, the assessing officer has grossly erred in taking the credits into the bank account of the assessee as business income and applying the rate of 8% on presumptive basis. He said that this amount should be taxed under section 68 as unexplained credits. The assessee challenged section 263 revision, that this revision is illegal because the same matter is pending before the CIT appeal, and the other submissions of the assessee was that I have filed the FIR, so some effort should be made on the part of the revenue to determine whether these accounts belong to me or not, or some local inspector should be appointed, or some this matter should be forwarded to the police authorities to determine whether my assertion that these accounts do not belong to me are correct or not. But no effort was made by the Commissioner of Income Tax, and he go ahead with the addition under section 263, read with section 68, and adding the whole amount into the income of the assessee. The assessee carried this matter to the tribunal, and when this matter was heard by tribunal, the tribunal said that in the present case, the revision under section 263 is not valid, because on the same ground, the appeal before the learned CIT appeal is pending, so revision cannot be made. Secondly, the tribunal was of the opinion that in the present case, the commissioner has proceeded without application of mind, merely reproducing the proposal made by the additional commissioner that the addition should be made under section 68. The tribunal said that there was no effort on the part of the commissioner to determine whether accounts belong to the assessee or not. The tribunal said that no inspector was deputed and it was assumed on the part of the commissioner that a poor man is assumed to be the owner of 112 crore. The tribunal said that none of the agencies has culminated the inquiry into a positive finding that whether the assessee is the owner of that money or not. The tribunal said that nobody recorded a specific finding that the plea of the assessee was false. The tribunal further said that in the present case, it was the duty of the commissioner to refer the matter to the police authorities and try to determine whether this amount belonged to the assessee or not. So on these grounds, the tribunal deleted or quashed the order passed by Commissioner of Income Tax under section 263 read with section 68. At the end of this video, once again I am repeating the name of the case. The name of the case is Rajesh Kumar Jalan versus Principal Commissioner of Income Tax, and this case has been reported in 113 ITR Tribunal at page number 188. The matter has been decided by Kolkata ITAT C Bench and the date of the judgment is 12th June 2024. Thank you, friends.